Pectus excavatum is a condition where the center of the chest curves inwards. Sometimes it may be asymmetrical, and the lower ribs may flare out. It can be present at birth, but typically gets deeper during adolescence. We're not sure what causes pectus excavatum, but it is more common in boys than in girls, can sometimes run in the family, and is due to extra cartilage growth around the sternum. Mild cases may not show any symptoms, but moderate cases can result in shortness of breath, fatigue, and decreased physical endurance. In severe cases, the sternum may compress the heart and lungs, causing chest pain or decreased lung capacity. People with severe cases can still have relatively normal levels of physical activity. Many also experience low self-esteem, social anxiety, and stigma due to the appearance of the chest. Although pectus excavatum is not life-threatening, surgery can restore volume to the chest, increase lung and heart capacity, and improve the appearance of the chest. The primary surgical option is the Nuss procedure. The Nuss procedure is a two-part, minimally invasive surgery that uses a temporary metal bar to push the sternum out. The bar acts like a brace for the sternum, allowing it to reform into a more correct position without breaking or cutting any ribs. Results are best in 12 to 16-year-olds, but can work in older patients as well. At Children's Hospital Colorado, we will examine your chest, which typically includes a CT scan of the chest, an echocardiogram, or other pulmonary function tests. The first surgery, the bar insertion, takes about 2 hours. You will be given general anesthesia, as well as a thoracic epidural, which will block most of your pain during recovery. First, your surgeon will create 3 small incisions, 2 1-inch incisions for the bar and a 1/4-inch one for the camera. Next, the bar is inserted between the ribs, brought in front of the heart and lungs, through a thin area of connective tissue under the sternum, and through to the other side. After the bar is positioned, it is rotated into place. This pushes the sternum out and corrects the curvature. Some patients may need 2 bars in severe cases. Finally, a metal stabilizer is placed on one side and absorbable sutures on both. Over several weeks, your body coats the bar with a thick sheath of fiber, securing it in place. The bar will stay in place for 2 to 4 years, depending on your age and how much growing you have left to do. During this time, the cartilage that was bent into place by the bar reforms into its new position. This stabilizes the sternum, so once the bar is removed, the sternum stays in place. The bar, however, does not correct the flared ribs. Most patients stay in the hospital for 3 to 5 days after surgery. Recovery from the Nuss procedure is often quite painful, but we will help you transition off the epidural and manage your pain using oral medication and may begin physical therapy as well. Once home, most patients get off their pain medication in 1 to 2 weeks and then return to school. After 3 to 4 weeks, most patients return to low-impact activities, such as running and swimming. After 3 months, patients can return to full activity, like weightlifting and even contact sports. For the second surgery, the bar removal, we will see you every 3 to 6 months until your bar is ready to be removed. Bar removal is a much simpler outpatient procedure and usually only takes an hour. First, the stabilizer is removed. Next, the bar is carefully taken out. The chances of the sternum reverting back to its original position are very low, less than 5%. Most patients will only need pain medication for 2 to 3 days after bar removal and return to full activity after 2 weeks with no long-term restrictions. We're ready to help you get better. To learn more, call us or visit our website below.